this video, we're going to take a closer look at Newton's second law. The second law says that the net force of an object equals the object's mass times its acceleration. This equation is useful for solving many types of problems involving motion. Let's try a few in order to get practice working with Newton's second law. Walking through a warehouse, you see a box on the floor. You decide to give it a push using a force of 25 newtons in the horizontal direction. If the box accelerates at 0.5 meters per second squared under this force, what is the mass of the box? Assuming the floor is frictionless, your push, which is an applied force, is the only horizontal force acting on the box. By Newton's second law, the strength of this push in newtons equals the box's mass in kilograms times its acceleration in meters per second squared. Dividing both sides of the equation by the acceleration, A, we see that the box's mass equals the applied force divided by A. We can now plug in the values we know for F applied and A. F applied is 25 newtons and A is 0.5 meters per second squared. The mass of the box is 25 newtons divided by 0.5 meters per second squared, which is 50 kilograms. Let's look at another example. Two runners line up to start a race. The first runner has a mass of 67 kilograms, while the second runner's mass is 73 kilograms. If runner 1 has an acceleration off the starting block of 6 meters per second squared, what force does the runner 2 need to exert in order to have the same acceleration? We have two different runners, and we want to match their acceleration at the start of the race. Written as an equation, we say that the acceleration of runner 1 equals the acceleration of runner 2. By Newton's second law, force equals mass times acceleration. The force of runner 2 equals mass times her acceleration. If we go back to our starting equation, that runner 1's acceleration equals the acceleration of runner 2, we can substitute that acceleration into our equation for runner 2's force and find that the force exerted by runner 2 equals the acceleration of runner 1 times the mass of runner 2. Plugging in the values for A1 and M2, we see that the force runner 2 needs to exert to accelerate just as much as runner 1 equals 6 meters per second squared times 73 kilograms, which equals 438 newtons or 440 newtons when using significant figures. Let's look at one more example. An ice skater skating in a straight line at 4 meters per second comes to a sudden stop in half a second. If the mass of the ice skater is 47 kilograms, how much force is exerted on her in coming to a stop? To solve this problem, we can use Newton's second law. The net force on the ice skater equals her mass times her acceleration. We are given her mass, but what about her acceleration? Remember that acceleration is defined as the change in velocity divided by the change in time. The skater's final velocity, 0 meters per second, minus her initial velocity, 4 meters per second, divided by 0.5 seconds, equals negative 8 meters per second squared. Now we can solve for the magnitude of the force acting on the skater as she stops. The force is the force due to friction, F sub F, and it equals the skater's mass, 47 kilograms, times her acceleration, negative 8 meters per second squared, which equals negative 376 newtons. The answer becomes negative 380 newtons when taken into account significant figures. This number is negative because the force due to friction acts opposite the positive direction we have given as to the right in this problem. That's our closer look at Newton's second law. For more physics in motion, go to our homepage, where the entire series is available to you.